The ANC National Executive Committee is leading this weekend's by-elections campaign in the Northwest. The campaign in Sekhwayelane is also aimed to woo potential voters to register for the upcoming local government elections. NEC member and State Security Minister Ayanda Dlodlo is among the members leading the campaign. Our reporter Barry Bateman has more.
We're out here in Sekhwayelane in the Madibeng district of rural Northwest, where the ANC is conducting a door-to-door campaign ahead of those by-elections scheduled for next month. Of course, this is the voter registration weekend. Now, for ENCA to just get out here, we have to come along potholed roads. There's a lot of underdevelopment in the area, and it does appear that the people are struggling. With me to discuss those issues is ANC NEC member Ayanda Dlodlo. And Minister, as I've just said there, we've come out here. You look at this area, it does appear underdeveloped. You have one of the residents here raising some issues with you. The question then is, why should this community vote for the ANC?
I think the biggest issue here that she also raises is not about housing. It's not about water. It's not about electricity. The issue that she raises is about roads. So I think between the ANC municipality and the mining community in this area, those things could be taken care of. And it could be a very quick fix because, as you would have heard, they did say that they did go to the mine, Sibanye, to request some of the soil that comes out of the mine, which easily absorbs water, unlike what they have here as the type of soil. So they have got the soil. The only problem is now transporting it so that it can be laid on the road to ensure that there is less of there is less of mud than there is some concrete type of structure that they're able to walk on and cars can move along. So it's not about roads. I mean, it's about roads. It's not about housing because, as you can see, the houses, although there are complaints about the workmanship, but people do have houses, there is water and there is electricity.
You say about a quick fix. We were just in the little town of Sonop, not far from here, where there does appear at some point there was roadwork. So half the job has been done, but it appears to have been abandoned. We don't know what the problem is, but if such an easy fix, why would a project where it does appear there was something underway get abandoned like that? So how is the ANC going to respond to issues like that?
Well, I think it's for the municipality to actually look into that, because you can't have a situation where roads are built by contractors, by the way, who are contracted by a government, a municipal government, at the level of local government, and you find work that has been abandoned. It could be varied reasons why the roads have been abandoned. It could be because the person that was contracted to do the road was not up to scratch. It could be because they were not able to plan and do a bill of quantities properly. So the reasons could be varied. I've not been to the area. It's one of the areas that we will be visiting. So I'll be able to give you better information once I get information on that.
And then just briefly, the big question is always, well, when are we going to see changes? We've got the elections coming up in a couple of months. Of course, we have political parties making all sorts of promises. Are these going to be empty?
Well, promises and commitments by political parties are what you see during an election process. You see that all over the world. It's not only with an ANC government. All political parties are going to come here and are also going to make the same commitments that we are making as well. But I think the real issue here is about ensuring that those commitments are actually lived, those commitments are actually executed so that our people can have better faith in an ANC government.
I'm going to ask you to put on your state security hat, and we're going to change tack. The Bowman's attorney firm pulled out of an investigation. How much of a blow is this to your efforts to clean up the state security agency?
You must remember, internally, we do have an investigating body. So whatever it is that they would have continued to do is not work that is lost. So working within the organization is continuing. We are collaborating with the Hawks. We are collaborating with the SIU. We are part of the Fusion Center in instances where certain investigations need to be made. So it's not as if the pulling out of Bowman's has had us halt our operations. Our operations on investigations are ongoing, and you would have seen over the past few weeks the reason why people are standing before court, standing trial for their transgressions, is because of the work that we did as SSA, not something that was discovered by the law enforcement agencies. So our work will continue. I've spoken to the National Treasury. The DG is going to be having a meeting with the DG of the National Treasury to ensure that out of their panel of investigators and auditors, we're able to select people that can come in and replace Bowman's.
Recent reports that there had been senior people appointed to positions of managers in the SSA, and these people had been tainted by some of the allegations at the Zondo Commission of Inquiry. Is there any truth to that? And if so, why are these kind of appointments happening?
You must remember that what was said at the Zondo Commission is inconclusive. In certain instances, there's no evidence that has been proffered. In certain instances, investigations are ongoing. People have been sitting at Musanda for a very long time, underutilized, with huge skills that could have helped the organization to be better than what it is today. So I'm not going to overlook transgressions, as I have said to you that I'm appointing a legal firm and a firm of auditors that will come in and do the work for us to support the work that we are internally doing. But at the same time, we can't have a situation where people are paid salaries that sit with skills that are required by the organization and underutilized, because investigations in that place over time has taken more than 2 years, 3 years. And it's just unfair on the individuals. And in some instances, a person is said to have stolen, say, for instance, 23 million rand, and he gets fired for a very flimsy reason, which means that there was no will at that point to properly investigate things and get people to book and have them pay what it is that that's stolen out of the organization. So what I am responsible for is ensuring that the organization is repurposed, we get the right skills and technologies in place so that we can be able to live by the expectations of our people.
Then just to conclude, you've got a new DG. What's top of the agenda?
Cleaning up the place and ensuring that those vacancies that have existed over a very long time are filled, and also ensuring that the cadet program is put in place so that we can recruit young people with skills that are required in the organization.
Minister, thank you very much for your time. Well, there you have it. On this very hot day out here in the Madibeng district in Northwest, the minister having spoken to, or the NEC member with that cap on, having spoken to community members, their concerns are roads. Minister Dlodlo saying that it's an easy fix and that they're going to get down to it. But moving on to the State Security Agency, the minister telling us that there are significant investigations that are underway, that Bowman's pulling out is not going to undermine the work that's already been done. And the top of the agenda item for the new Director General is to clean up the organization. Barry Bateman, Northwest.